Okay. I'll move to something called as capital structure. We had done leverages, we have done cost of capital, we have done. Now we are going to learn about capital structure. These three were part of a single chapter earlier. It was technically called as financing decisions. In that financing decision, we have done two parts of it. The first part was cost of capital. The second part was leverages. In cost of capital, cost of debt, cost of equity, cost of preference, all of that. Okay, any idea what is capital structure? What do you mean by capital structure? Yeah. Composition of debt, equity and preference. Debt, equity. Any idea what do you mean by term capital? You would have used this word at multiple places. What do you mean by capital? Funds for? No, so what start, what is? Okay, initial amount invested. It's not initial amount. Later on it can even change. So what is capital? What do you mean by capital? No, not required. No, funds which are sourcing the fixed assets need not be capital. You will also have working capital that will also will be funded out of capital. Now, in your accountancy, you would have learned term capital means owner's money. That is what capital is all about. In finance, the term capital means long-term money. What is long-term? Debt, equity, preference. Even debt is part of capital. We use a term called as debt capital. Preference capital, like equity capital and preference capital, there is also a term called as debt capital, because debt holders are also owners of the company indirectly. A person, SBI, when it gives a loan, it is technically taking a risk on the business and it wants the company to perform well. Because if the company doesn't perform well, their money will get stuck. So what finance says is that the term capital means long-term money. Long-term money means debt, equity and preference. And the objective of capital structure is the composition of this money in order to minimize an item called as cost of capital. You would have learnt about cost of capital earlier in the cost of capital chapter, which is nothing but WACC. Your WACC can reduce if equity reduces, cost of equity, cost of debt, cost of preference, or you change the composition. When you change the mix also, WACC will undergo a change. Now, what has this theory said is that the objective of this financing decision is that you will have to source your capital in such a way that you can minimize the cost of capital. Where do I use cost of capital? I use it for some purpose. We use cost of capital for some purpose. You have learnt it somewhere. We use it for some purpose. When you do your capital budgeting decision, in step 4, year, cash flow, PVF at some rate you put, no, that some rate is nothing but cost of capital. PVF at, so if you have a very high cost of capital, what will happen is your NPV will be less. If you have a low cost of capital, your NPV will be better. So based on cost of capital, you can have a positive NPV, you can have a negative NPV. So if a company has a very high cost of capital, it will most probably be rejecting a lot of projects, because all those projects will lead to negative NPV. Most probably it has to reject a lot of projects. So the objective is to minimize the cost of capital. When you minimize the cost of capital, step 4 of capital budgeting, year, cash flow, PVF, DCF. This PVF at the rate can be lesser, and when that rate is lesser, you are benefited in the form of better NPV. That is what this chapter is all about. The chapter says, capital structure is a combination of capital from different sources, consists of equity, preference, long-term external debt. The source, there are a lot of capital structure theories. I'll come to that in some time. I'll come to capital structure theories as I do problems. Now, there is a way in which you calculate the value of the firm. There are a lot of capital structure theories which have come. These theories have made some assumptions. The first assumption of the theory is there are only two forms of capital. Only two forms. Just wait, wait. Just a minute. ठीक है, आई फर्स्ट सॉल्व दीज सेट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स एंड देन आई कम टू द टू फॉर्म्स ऑफ कैपिटल. नाउ फर्स्ट थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इज ऑप्टिमम मिक्स. ऑप्टिमम मिक्स बेसिकली रेफर्स टू द डिफरेंट मिक्स ऑफ डेट, इक्विटी एंड प्रेफरेंस. देयर इज अ मिक्स व्हिच इज डिफरेंट फॉर डेट, इक्विटी एंड प्रेफरेंस. ए मिक्स ऑफ डेट, इक्विटी एंड प्रेफरेंस व्हिच मैक्सिमाइजेस द वैल्यू ऑफ द फर्म. योर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू मैक्सिमाइज द वैल्यू ऑफ द फर्म. How do I calculate value of the firm? Everything I'll explain with the problem. Basic thing which you are going to learn in capital structure is the mix of debt, equity and preference which will maximize the value of the firm or minimize the cost of capital. If you minimize the cost of capital, value will get maximized. Clear? Any doubts? Any doubts? So what we are going to learn is what is the mix of debt, equity and preference is the right for this company. There are certain companies which don't have debt. Infosys is a zero debt company. TCS is a zero debt company because they feel zero debt is beneficial for them. Reliance has a lot of debt in their balance sheet. So different companies will work differently. Some companies will prefer having debt. Some companies will prefer not having debt. Some companies will have preference capital. Some companies will not have. What you are basically learning is what is the composition of debt, equity and preference which is best for the company. Clear? Now let's start with this question then. Come to page 55. Go through question 1. Let's start with this. How much is the money required for capital expenditure? 25 lakhs. Now, this 25 lakhs can be raised in three forms: debt, equity, and preference. The question may give you what they want to do. Now, they are saying it has three alternatives: raising debt of 250. So, first option is 250 of debt, 2250 of equity. 2,50,000 of debt and 2,50,000 of equity. Second is 10 lakhs of debt and balances equity. Third is 15 lakhs of debt and balances equity. It could have also been 10 lakhs debt, 10 lakh preference, 5 lakh equity. The question can give different information. So first you need to find out what are the ways in which you are going to raise the money. Working note 1, identification of alternatives. Working note 1, identification of alternatives. Alternative 1, working note 1, identification of alternatives. Alternative 1, debt of rupees 2,50,000 and equity of rupees 22,50,000. Debt of 2,50,000 and equity of rupees 22,50,000. You have an entire requirement of 25 lakhs, 2,50,000 from debt guys, 2,250,000 from equity guys. Alternative 2. Any doubts on this? Alternative 2 is debt of 10 lakhs and equity of 15 lakhs. Debt of 10 lakhs and equity of 15 lakhs. Then alternative 3, debt of 15 lakhs and equity of rupees 10 lakhs. Next, working note 2, calculation of interest, comma, preference dividend and number of shares. Calculation of interest, comma, preference dividend and number of shares. Interest, comma, preference dividend and number of shares for various alternatives. Interest, comma, preference dividend and number of shares for various alternatives. Particulars in three columns. Alternative 1, now whatever I am giving you is a longer route. I could have easily got to the answer directly itself, but whatever steps I am giving, I can end up using the same for next 6-7 problems. So we will end up using it this way rather than I am giving different steps to the different question. It's little a longer route rather than taking it an easier route. Easier route is straight away I could have done working note 3. Working note 3 could have been straight away done, but let me do it in a detailed route. Now write interest and underline that. Interest and underline that. Below that, existing, additional and total. Existing, additional and total. You can end up even leaving few steps of this as you proceed later on. You will understand that. Existing means, till now, if the company was in existence, then they would be paying some interest. Look at the question and tell me, is there any interest being paid by the company now? Till now, any interest? Not for this 25 lakhs ka project. any information there in the question? If nothing is there, it means it's a newly formed company. It could be a newly formed company. So existing is 0, 0 and 0. Existing is 0, 0 and 0. Sometimes they'll say the company is currently paying an interest of 5 lakh rupees. Then 5 lakh, 5 lakh, 5 lakh for all the three. You will write 5 lakh, 5 lakh, 5 lakh for all the three. Any doubts on this? Alternative one, what is the debt we are taking? Can you multiply with the interest rate and tell me what is the additional interest? 20? 2,50,000 into 10%. 2,50,000 into 10%, which is 25,000. Any doubts on this? Clear? You can proceed. Next, in the second option, how much debt are we taking? Can you tell me the interest? Don't write it. Tell me the interest. 1 lakh. What is the interest for 10 lakhs of debt? Amount, amount. Tell me the amount. I'll discuss. I don't want you to write anything. 1 lakh? Is it 137,500 or 150? Okay. Now, there are two ways of thinking. One is your slab structure, which is an income tax. What happens is, for the first, this is the rate. For the next, this is the rate. For the next, this is the rate. The other way of understanding is that the moment you exceed 250, for the entire debt, it is going to be 15%. Institute has taken it to be a slab structure. That is, for the first 2,50,000, it will be 10%. And only for the incremental, which is more logical, because till 2,50,000, I can get it at 10%. For extra amount, I will pay 15%. For further extra amount, I will pay 20%. So, the calculation is 25,000 plus 7,50,000 into 15%. The extra is only on 7,50,000. The extra amount is only on 7,50,000. The extra interest rate. Alternatively, you will put for entire stuff 15%. That you will have to write a note. This is how Institute has interpreted in this question. 137,500. Any doubts on this? Clear? Next one. Existing, sorry, this 137,500 is still 10 lakhs. Beyond that, how much money we want? 5 lakhs, and that will be at 20%. Any doubts on this? 37,500, 137,500 and 237,500. Then we get the total interest. This much is the interest we are going to pay in the three options. 25,000, 137,500 and 237,500. 25,000, 137,500 and 237,500. Clear? Then, preference dividend. Preference dividend. Preference dividend. More of a formality, you can write everything as zero. There is no existing, there is no additional. Everything is zero. I don't have any existing preference dividend. I also don't add any new preference capital. So everything is zero. I'm doing this so that it is useful in some other question. Existing is zero. Additional is also zero. Next, equity shares. Next item is equity shares. Equity shares. Again, existing, additional and total. equity shares, existing, additional and total. What's the existing equity shares? Existing is 0. Additional, in the first option, 22,50,000 of equity share value is required. You have the issue price. Can you tell me what will be the number of shares? What is the issue price? 1. But is expected to decline to 125 if the borrowings are some 10 lakhs or something. So it's 150 rupees. Listen for some time. In option 1, 22,50,000 divided by 150 ka price. Any doubts? 22 lakh, write the amount. 22,50,000 divided by 150. 22,50,000 divided by 150. Option 2. 15 lakhs divided by? 150 or 125? It's 150 because 125 is if you borrow more than 10 lakhs. It's if you borrow more than 10 lakhs. Be very careful about those aspects. It's 15 lakh divided by 150 itself. So the first one is 15,000. Second one is 10,000. Third one will be divided by 125. Third one will be divided by 125, 10 lakhs by 125. Clear? Can you proceed? Done. Next working note, calculation of EPS. Calculation of EPS, particulars and three alternative. Particulars and three alternatives. Particulars and three alternative. Now, when you calculate EPS, the starting point is EBIT. When we did leverages, we used to start with sales, less variable cost, contribution, less fixed cost, EBIT. My starting point is going to be EBIT, less interest will come from working note 2, EBT, less tax, EAT, less preference dividend, again from working note 2, EA, ES, number of equity shares from working note 2, EPS. So that is why we have calculated all of those basic information. Now start with EBIT. The question will give the EBIT information. What's the EBIT? That has to remain the same for all the three. EBIT is 5 lakhs. EBIT 5 lakhs. Less interest. The format is already introduced to you when we were doing leverages. Less interest. This will be different for different alternatives. You have this in working note 2. It will be different for different alternatives. The figure is there in working note 2. already done the calculation for that. Less interest. EBIT less interest. You get EBT, EBIT less interest, EBT. There will be a tax rate given in the question. What's the tax rate? How much? Less tax at 50%. Less tax at 50%. We will get EAT less tax at 50%. EAT. I'm not introducing any new format, the format remains same. EAT from EAT, it is less. More of a formality in this question. Later on, you can even skip this because we don't have any preference dividend. Less preference dividend, zero. Less preference dividend, zero. We could have avoided this also, but let's write it as a format. Less preference dividend. EAES. EAES 237, 500, 181, 250 and 131, 250. After EAES, we have number of shares and EPS. Number of shares and EPS. Number of shares and then EPS. EPS is 15.83, 18.125 and 16.40625. Any doubts on this? Clear? Anybody has any doubts on this? Now, my objective is to maximize EPS. If EPS is maximum, the firm returns will also be maximized. Any doubts till now? Now, write conclusion. The company should go ahead with alternative 2 in brackets 10 lakhs of borrowing and 15 lakhs of equity close brackets to maximize its EPS. Clear? Any doubts on this? Now, they've asked which form of financing should the company choose. The question did not say that you have to maximize EPS. They just said which form of financing should the company choose. Now, I have two ways of answering this. One, I go for maximization of EPS. But maximizing EPS does not mean the firm will get better, because EPS is only for equity shareholder. You also have a debt holder in a company. So sometimes the question will give you an information called as P multiple. if P multiple is there, then I have to go till value of firm. I'll do it and then I'll tell you to do it. Rework is a scenario, right? Rework if the P multiple is, if the P multiple is 10, 9, 8, 10, 9 and 8 for 3 alternatives. Rework if the P multiple is 10, 9 and 8 for the 3 alternatives. Some multiple the question has given, 10, 9 and 8. Now listen, we have done till EPS, P multiple 10, 9 and 8 if the P multiple is available. EPS into P multiple is what? EPS into P multiple. What do you get? Market price of a share. EPS into P multiple. Listen for some time. Don't focus on copying this. This will be the share price. This can be the share price for the three scenarios. EPS into P multiple. If at all P multiple is there. Wait for some time. The number of shares market value of equity. Market price means for a single share, value means for all the shares put together. So I'll get something called as market value. This will turn out to be the market value. There is a formula for market value of firm. Market value of firm is equal to debt plus equity plus preference. All these three people are owners of the company. So you'll have to add debt, equity and preference. So if a question gives me P multiple, I can get the market value of shares. With market value of shares, we will add market value of debt, market value of preference. In this question, preference is 000. Debt is whatever we had taken, 2,50,000, 10 lakhs, and then it was 10 lakhs. Again, we are going to go with second alternative only because that gives me the maximum value. It can change if the P multiple instead of 9, if it was some 8.5. then the second alternative may not be the better one. For example, instead of this 10, 9, 8, if it was 11, 9, 8, the question gives you 11, 9 and 8, then the first alternative is better than the second alternative because the value is 28 lakh here. So you will have to calculate the value of the firm and then decide which is better if a P multiple is available, because objective is always to maximize value of firm. If I don't have P multiple, EPS is the proxy for that. So you go with maximization of EPS. So listen, after EPS, you'll now particulars and three columns you'll put EPS as per the earlier working note. MPS, sorry, EP multiple gives you MPS, number of shares, market value of equity, debt, preference, and then you get the market value of firm. Please do this. Don't copy it, try to do it. you start with EPS, multiply with P multiple, this is the format. The format is already there for you in your material. I have already given the format. Complete this. With that, we'll end today's session. I'll continue in the next class. Complete this.